wonder what they're like.
From our viewpoint, Professor, they're either suprahuman or subhuman.
Welcome to Sunday Night Stream. My name is Jayrod. I didn't feel like playing Magic tonight, so I am going to just play some Minecraft. Because no one's around to tell me I can't. Hopefully everything's coming through. I did the unforgivable sin of upgrading OBS. And this is the first thing I'm doing since upgrading. So we'll see if it works fine. Gonna get into a world I've been... got a few hours in. I'm already, like, upgraded to stuff and such. So I've got, like, fully kitted out. Well, mostly fully kitted out. But I do want to... have some music that they have in the background, just since I'm not going to be playing any of my own. So yeah, it's a little choppy, but should be alright. I may also just... yeah, there's the music. I like their kind of basic music. Ah! What a way to start. And that's already too loud for me, so. Nope, master volume's fine. Turn the music down some. There we go. So yeah, I wanted to just play a little bit of this. Gonna have some fun. I may or may not be digging a giant hole again. I've already done it once, and I'll show you. A few people who follow us may know that some of us are big fans of Loading Ready Run, and they have a thing where they punch an entire chunk in Minecraft, which is a 16 by 16 square from all the way up top to all the way down. I've decided to do that. I did it once already, and turn it into basically my mineshaft. So I think one of the things I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do it again. I'll just pick one a little further over. Zombie? I know I heard a zombie. So yeah, and then one other thing I wanna try to do is make a farm to grow pumpkins and melons, because I have a farmer I can trade with and get emeralds for. So yeah, I'll start by digging some, just to pass the time. It's kind of a rare Sunday, in that it is the fifth Sunday of the month, and we usually only try to do, like, we have it split up in a way that we try to only have, like, two a month, if we can manage it. But I volunteered to take the third. third Sunday. I don't want to go too far over this way. But I hadn't really discussed what I was going to do or anything like that, so... Yeah, because I want to be in range of my animals and my farm on the other side of that hill. I'll show everyone. And I have a trading area over there in the already built village. I made myself a little rail going over to it. But yeah, I think I will dig a hole similar to that hole right in this general area. And I do it slightly different than they do on the Loading Ready Run channel, where I don't take my tools down to exactly one durability or anything like that. But I do need to use this. If you hold F3 and G, it shows you the grid lines, and you can see a chunk. Which, if you're not familiar with the game, is kind of how the game is loaded. Like, for me, anything within, like, I think maybe like a 10 chunk radius is loaded, and everything else is not. So if I moved like 20 chunks in that direction, my bamboo and my animals, they would not be loaded, so they would stop like laying eggs for the chickens and stuff. So yeah, I think this one's just about as good as any. So I guess I'll start with this one. So, start by chopping down a tree. And I'll dig until my tools get to, like, in the yellowish durability. Alright, oop, that tree is also in the chunk. And the leaves will naturally take care of themselves. So one thing that they do is dig one layer at a time, which I will be doing. It's kind of like a brain off, take care of simple task. Lot of branches in this chunk, but that's fine. Alright, so I think what I might do after I get a little further down, like when I get even to the ground down there, I'll head back over and grab a few items, like a few chests and stuff. Where am I starting, by the way? Level 71. Okay. Oh dear God. Hi. Nope, come here. I just want to talk to you. Alright, fine. fun. Alright, so those should go away on their own. Yeah. Let's keep digging. Once I'm down a little further, I'll turn off the grid lines. Do I have any breaking? Yeah. Good. Yeah, the first chunk I did was all stone, and it took me like 12 hours. I doubt I'll finish this one today, just because I'm not going to stream that much past, like, that deep into the night to where I'm going to finish this. But I'll probably get down a decent clip, hopefully down to deep slate. Alright, time to go sleep. So maybe I'll just go ahead and grab some stuff now to make this a little easier. Oop. Oop. Turn those off for a minute. So here's all the stuff I gathered from the first time I did this. At some point, but not for a little while, because I've got a whole stack at the moment. Bones, meat, gunpowder. So chests I'll need, just to put stuff in. And I'll set a bed over there, just so I have something a little closer to where I'm doing stuff. This, so kind of light up the area a little bit just to prevent stuff from sneaking up on me too much. Alright, that should be good. That's in the chunk. Alrighty. Let's get back to it. For what I hope is a good guess of where to start the letter. doing this with stone tools takes a lot longer, as you can suspect. Unenchanted stone tools are very slow. Do love the sound of just blocks breaking, though. It's been a very therapeutic, relaxing activity of just digging a hole. Five copper from one ore. I love it. I have the full fortune 3 on my pick, so I can get bonus stuff. I brought a bed and all that other stuff. Didn't actually put anything down. So I think what I'll do, I'll pick up all this copper, and then I'll go do that real quick. Did I put my bed? Oh, right, I didn't pick a spot yet. That's right. Like, where'd I put my bed? We just discussed this. Yeah. chests. They never do what I want them to do. Alright, so this far left will be rich stuff. I got a dirt chest and a stone chest. Alright, I'll probably need more chests. Oh, look at that. So I also picked up that and that. Yeah, so once I get kind of low on durability, I'll kind of show off some of the other stuff I have and repair my tools a bit. We'll see where that takes us as far as time. Honestly, it's the pick that is the only one that's going to be in need of repair. We can definitely repair stuff on the way to that time as well. Like, I'll make a temporary furnace for down here and use the coal that I'm about to dig up to melt up some copper, and when I find iron as well, I guess I better find iron. I agree, Tim. All cheese does rule. Thank you for seeing my going live message. I was like, you know what? We don't really utilize that as much as we should, I don't think. Mozzarella's a good one. It's probably one of our most used too. It goes on a lot of things. But we also do a lot of cheddar related recipes, like quesadillas. And honestly, like if you do homemade pizzas, mozzarella and cheddar together, Recommend. Mixing the cheeses is how you get the best cheeses. Like Colby Jack? Yes. Mix Colby and Monterey Jack. And that's when the big bucks roll in. Oop. Nobody saw that. Was an angry huh? Where is it? Where are they? That's the sound of doom. Don't be right here. You're right there. Of course you're right there. Where's the rest of you? I don't know if I'm gonna do a whole web series on cheese, but I could definitely do a few specials. Where are these jerks? Uh-huh, yeah. Are you in a different hole? Besides mine? There's always more than one. Where the heck did they go? I can hear them, but I can't see them. Ow. Okay, I can hear somebody right there. Find these things. Oh, you're a wandering trader. Where did you come from? Did you kill the other pillagers? I mean, I could tell you didn't sound like one of them, but I still don't know how you did that. All right, cool. I also don't know where your llamas are, so I'm very concerned. Did they have a fight to the death and you somehow became victorious, or what happened there? I hear ya. I just don't care. Huh? freaking me out, man. Come on. Something on this. Unbreaking one. Cool. It is very relaxing. No, we're just digging. Actually, I'll show you, since you weren't here at the beginning. We're digging all the way down. This is the first time I've streamed it, but I've been playing in this world for a little while, like a month and a half now. We're digging all the way down. And I did it once before, but I did it with, like, stone and iron tools, so it was very slow. But, there's a llama. I can't rescue you. But we're digging all the way down to bedrock, which is all the way down there. Excuse me. Pardon. Sorry. Oh no! Oh crap, I didn't. Oh no, how terrible! Oh my god, he keeps landing on my platforms. This is no place for a llama, but I can't get him up, so he's gotta go the other way. If you survive this, you'll be Pit Llama. Lorenzo Llama. Alright, there. You can live in there now. That's your new home. Anyway, yeah, so I just dug all the way down. And then I turned it into a mineshaft, where I just created little pathways to get around to different resources in the wall. Although I clearly missed some. That's fine. I have plenty of copper. It took a while. But it's a fun, relaxing way to play this game. And then I just was like, instead of just doing it the way I've seen other streamers do it, I was like, I'll do it as a kickstart to, like, using it as a mineshaft, but it's a bonus Sunday, basically. So I was like, I'll just, stream me digging a hole for a while. Very interesting. Right, back to it. I'm hoping to get down a little ways before I have to repair my tools. I still hear you. Why don't you come down here and say that? Yeah, yeah. Dig in a hole. I want to do. Just dig a hole. Figure I'll see how far I get in a couple of hours and kind of go from there. Surprisingly, though, I didn't actually hit lava in the previous hole, so I took that as a good fortune, because it's not easy to deal with in this format, but at this point I wouldn't have too much trouble, because I could turn it into obsidian. My pick's pretty good, so I can get it taken care of, not terribly slowly. Lorenzo Llama will be fine. I hope. We'll go visiting. Do something special. Aside from showing off all the other times I had pillagers come in to my area. Go down here to my garden / fishing area. He's still alive. I guess we'll find out. Those zombies don't sound too happy. Lorenzo? You still here, buddy? Oh, heavens. this is where we left them. Yes! Hey, buddy. There you go. You stride majestically through the caves. Okay, bye. There. Now we'll know he's safe. I'm sure he'll have plenty of zombie flesh to feast on down there. Because based on the fact that there was only one pillager, I'm pretty sure the other llama and Lorenzo took out the other ones. That's the only thing that makes sense. Well, might as well stay here. Yes, laser eyes indeed. Laser eyes and laser voice. Cut down this other tree so I can make more chests. Because I'm gonna need them. Okay, that's good. Smeltables over here. Are you still going? Oh, that's fine. I'm not gonna star in laser voice. That ain't me, man. If you ask Max, I'm more likely to be robot voice because of whenever I record a podcast, it usually comes out like a robot. Sound like. Follow that bird with robot voice. Just maybe. Sounded like a deep roll. Did the rest of the things show up again? Huh? Still just you, huh? Have you seen anybody else around here? No? Anybody in there? I don't know what to tell you. Come over here. Stand in the pit. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Nobody saw that. Doop doop doop. Exactly. Relaxing digging. It's calm and relaxing, even with the traitor who won't shut up. It's a good way to end the month of streaming. Relax, dig. And once my pick gets to like a quarter durability, I'll try to repair it some. I'll have to fix that, I'll dig that in a minute. I have another couple projects I want to try. dark. Wait, this is the rich beans. Gravel. Let's fill this with cobblestone. A net. That other stone will go here, so... Gravel, line for diorite. Dirt. Flint. Okay. Do one more walk around just to see if I can see anything suspicious. I literally have nothing to say to you. I don't want brown dye. Dark oak sapling is the only thing I'm kind of interested in. But all my emeralds are with my villagers, so I'm sorry. I keep it in the bank. Aha! Where are you? There you are! How'd you get stuck in there? Well, you wasted your shot. Okay. Oop. All right, so I have to do one quick thing so I don't accidentally start a raid on my village. Do-do-do-do-do. Store that one there. Milk, for some reason, gets rid of bad effects. Hooray, milk. I knew I heard one more. But way over there. It's pretty wild. Are you sure there's no other ones? It's usually like three or four, I thought. All right. But I must just walk right into a pool. That would have been silly. Back to digging. going to be very serious when it comes to this. Like I said, I've been playing on this world for like a month and a half. I don't actually have a base yet. I just have a field of chests and fences for animals. So, digging a hole. That's about what I do. Nothing too fancy. So easy to dig real fast with a shovel. Think of all the base stones, it's one of my favorite looking ones. Especially polished granite. I should really build something on this server. Not even server, it's just a single player world. I should really build something on it though. Lorenzo is, he can be what I build. My kingdom around Lorenzo. Andesite, gravel, andesite. A lot of andesite. Probably need more chests for stone soon. One is not enough, I know. Thank you. That's so much copper. These leaves didn't despawn because this other tree's still here. Fascinating. Oh well. Over here. Bloop. Yeah. Got 4 pearls off that? Holy crap. Suppose I can just leave this here too. Doop doop doop. Right. Back to our regularly scheduled pit. So I'll leave grass in there since it's technically not dirt. Okay. It was good to know that I can an Enderman, though. Those things are weird and terrifying, but I'll need their pearls? Enderman eggs, whatever you want to call them. Because I eventually would like to get to the end. There's some iron. Like, I have a decent amount, but the one project, the pumpkin and melon farm, I might need more than what I have. Yep. Eggs and iron. I have plenty of chicken for actual eggs, too. Need llama eggs. Oh dear God. I want to know. Those aren't eggs, Tim. Bad Tim. Woohoo, two with fortune. I don't know if I have the wherewithal to construct an idol to a llama, but I will keep that in mind for a future build. Also, he's not dead. Had we lost Lorenzo llama, then I'm much more likely to do that. But I haven't seen the message to say Lorenzo died. Because I think now that we name tagged him, that would happen. There's a chance that he did somehow become fallen down a pit and didn't die. I'll be answering no more questions. I already have two. I'd like to end up with more than four. Five. Well, I got what I wanted. Okay. How far down are we? We started at like 71. Is that right? 48. Let's see where the top of the ladder is. Doing pretty good though. About 23-ish full layers down. Still 837 on the pick. Once I get down to like 700 durability, if I don't have another load of copper to smelt up, I'll take the dig break and try to remember how to build a pumpkin melon farm. I've seen it done recently enough on a video that I think I should be good. How many plants? That's a very good question, Tim. I think I want to do. I might try to see it at least once in theaters, but I'm cautiously optimistic about it. But I don't know. It could go either way. Like, the previews definitely have me looking forward to seeing it, but I don't know. And not to say that this is a bad thing, but it definitely seems like it's geared slightly more towards a younger audience. Which it probably should be, but for, you know, the people who grew up with the 87 cartoon, that kind of throws it into a bit of a confusing situation where it's like, oh, these are actually teenage versions of the characters. It's like, wait, I don't understand. You know, it's not adults playing these characters anymore. These are actually kids. So to answer your question, I have no idea. Why didn't I put away literally everything else that's in my inventory? Good God. I mean, that is absolutely what I'm hoping for out of this, you know, this version of the Turtles, is that it just keeps new people coming into enjoying the franchise. Yeah, absolutely. Like, it definitely is a franchise that deserves to continue on. So, that's all we can hope for. Oops. Okay. really good. Alright, well. Might as well just go back to a full stack. I'll pick up more sticks. Aha, there was more loads. A bunch more. That's good enough. One other thing about the Turtles movie that I do actually, like, I think will be pretty great. The kid that plays Raphael, Brady Noon, he's actually pretty great, because he was in the Mighty Ducks series, the Game Changers that was on Disney Plus. It's only 2 seasons, and it got canceled already, but that was a lot of fun. Like, I had a lot of fun watching that show, and he was, like, the main kid on it. And definitely recommend that. So, he definitely gives a Raphael vibe in that show a little bit. You know, sort of an aggressive hockey player at points, so. It's like a combination of Casey Jones and Raphael. It's perfect. He's not, like, a kid goon. There's a few that are that, but... No, he's definitely more like the Charlie character from the original movies, where he's the young kid with a lot of talent, but he plays on the team that is a bunch of misfits. The plucky underdogs, as it were. It's a good continuation of the story. Plucky Duck. Exactly. Not a coincidence. There was definitely a few pretty great cameos. There was more I would have loved to have seen, And I thought they were setting up for it to happen, but it never did. And then Disney Plus, at the moment, is not renewing it, unfortunately. But, yeah, it's 2 seasons of pretty fun television. And it's a quick watch, honestly. I think it's like 8 to 10 episodes each season, and none of them are more than like 35-ish minutes. So, yeah, if you're taking a break from a movie, definitely try to fit that in there. And then just watch the 3 Mighty Ducks movies while you're at it. Because why not? Yeah, exactly. That's why you should watch the Mighty Ducks movies, so they're not all awful movies. I do have another idea that I want to present to Max that he should do for his movie watching. But that can wait till tomorrow in our secret meeting that Tim is a part of. But you don't know that. I mean, Tim probably knows that, but the audience doesn't, except for right now. But I'm pretty sure at the moment, the entire audience is Tim. Unless I post this to YouTube, then shh. Through this layer, go up and heal my pick a bit with the copper that's in there, get more smelting. And basically, once I run out of copper, I'll get working on the other project, which shouldn't take me more than an hour, I'm hoping. Copper llama statue would be nice. I do have quite a bit of copper already back at my home base. Because fortune I got pretty early on, and I found a lot of copper the other day. This is kind of like Mario 64, like menu music, and I love it. Mario 64. I don't think I actually beat it for the Nintendo 64, but I did beat it on the DS. And so much fun. Finish this layer and head back up. Spyglass as well. That was a perfectly set up amount of copper. Do-do-do. Alright, so I'm back up to 791. So I will dig a bit more. Do a couple more layers and then see where I'm at. Yeah, the knuckle cracking can get kind of rough after holding my mouse down like I have to for this. Felt good though. I'll have to mute next time I have to crack my knuckles. Or any part of me, honestly. I'm basically a tree. Start creaking and cracking whenever the wind blows. You like the scary noise, okay? Do you at least want a warning, or just I go for it whenever I feel the need? You keep me posted on what you prefer. Let him rip. It's a terrifying concept when it comes to my fingers, but sure. Hand-ripping carpal tunnel fun. Ugh. Terrifying concept, that is. Alright, so exactly 700. I'll finish this layer and go check the copper. Actually, I'll finish this layer and hit those pieces of coal to get a bit of XP and see where I'm at after that. So 6:45. That's not bad, but I think it's about that time. Because I'll probably need my pick to actually build the thing. And that's only halfway through, so. Alrighty. Granite, andesite. Stone, coal. All right. You know what? Stuff we don't need for what we're about to do. All right. So for this, I'll need. Should be good. Pistons, observers, pumpkin seeds, melon slices. Turn those into melon seeds. I definitely have more than I need of all of these things. So let's find dirt's down here. Actually, what I do need, I need to grow a single pumpkin first. Glowstone. Maybe I will. I'll see what the pumpkin does, but. Alright. Quick distraction adventure. Stuff I'll be taking over to. Oh, by the way, I have a bunch of other llamas. But anyway, gonna go see if I can quick find some glowstone, because I would love to get one for the farm I'm about to build. I don't have to worry about going to bed since I'm going to a dark dimension. The evil dimension. There's not dark llamas, but there are other terrifying things here in the Nether, like flying ghosts. Alright, so there's some glowstone. It's way too high up for me to get, so let's try to find some easier to mine glowstone. Ooh, shroom lights actually could work. I think. Ugh. just make sure my video settings are all the way bright, because there's a good chance that you'll have a hard time seeing, because this is a dark and scary place. What's up? Hi. How's it going? Oh god, there's Enderman here too. Oh, if I don't look at them, I'll be fine. Come on. Why is there no glowstone above here, where it's safe? Yeah. Oh god. Ah. There's two of them. That is terrifying and scary. Oh, that hit him. Okay, well, I'm not going back there. Is there seriously no glowstone in any of these areas? Like, nothing. Are you kidding me? This is awful. It's terrifying. I'm going the other way. Yeah. Yeah, these dark llamas are in fact ghosts, and they spit fire. Salt. That's fun. Useless, but fun. Okay. Oh, come on. Ah. Ah. I was hitting it with my shovel. I'm a freaking idiot. We're having a wonderful time. Ooh, quartz. come on, man. There's glowstone right over there, and there's a thousand freaking things. What are you over here? Just a magma slime? Okay. Go! Stack. I'm heading back. Ow. Jeez, where are you? This way. Yeah, it's definitely this way. Terrifying ghost cat sounds. All this because I wanted something to light up my project. That was it. Nothing too crazy. Just a little bit of glowstone. Nothing like getting distracted and then getting lost in literal Minecraft hell. It's fine, though. It's fine. It's right over this hill. Yeah, I hear you. Take a second to eat some more steak. I still have 41 arrows. I can see his ugly little legs. Thank you. hate you guys. I hate you guys so much. You're all useless and mean and hell. Yeah. Please go home. Go home. That's what happens when you don't go home. Well, all that also got me a bunch of XP to heal up my pick some, but no. We're gonna go ahead and start with the project. So yeah, technically I only needed 4. I wouldn't eat that spam. That's zombie spam. Old spam. Alright. So I don't actually need any more nether quartz at the moment, so that can go in there. And then all the other random crap that I found can go in there. Do I have enough? Yeah, I have enough arrows for the moment. Alright. I want to make this out of cobble deep slate. Also need some rails. Need more sticks. Better go with a little bit more. Alright, and then okay. So I think I want to build it over here-ish. I suppose I didn't need to grab the dirt that I grabbed. I don't need that big of an area, but I just want to make sure I have enough room. That's fine. So, just to make sure. Perfect. Alright, so. To be 7x7, so I don't actually need this entire last row. So where do I... Where will it end? Shoot. Nah, that's fine. I have an idea. Need to go to bed. Okay. Now, don't need that. Don't need it's always something. You know, I'll just keep building, and then when I actually reach the point that I need to do a different thing, I'll do that. Yep, I'm gonna be here for a bit. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Well, that's not what I want. This line. Okay. I don't actually have to go that far then. But I do need to go all the way down. Sure. I'll mark it with that. Right. this count? What happened? Yes, I did. Because this row doesn't need one. I'm so bad at this game. I got one right. I got one right. Okay. Okay. Two right. Okay. Put some dirt in the hopper. Six. Okay. So clearly I need a couple more hoppers, but I have three more. That should be good. It's not going to be that productive. I'm not going to always have a full stack of stuff coming in and out of the minecart. So, it's more like 32. So, 13 on that go. That's not bad. Okay. So the unloading process will work just fine. Why did I go to that? I wanted to go to bed. Okay. Thank you. Minecraft rules, but I love it. I think I could actually go bigger now that I'm looking at it. I think I could go 9x9, but I'm just gonna make it 7x7. It's easier for me. All right. Because it's just me. I don't need it to be anything fancy. I didn't bring enough bones. Pumpkin. Bat. Melon. Let's grow that fast, but sure. What if I was supposed to do this later? I think they're all good, actually. Okay, so next. Stairs work. So I need. Oh, come on, man. All right, I'll take care of that in a minute. So over. Blank blocks, I need the pistons. And then over the other blocks, I need the observers. Okay, this is where dirt comes in. Actually, nope. Eh. can I just place these on there? Yes. So far, yes. I'll just go ahead and that run for a bit. What was I about to grab? Oh my god. Pressure plate. I'm so good at this game. Cool. Stop. Relax. You're fine. There you go. Go down, son. Thank you. Hello. Help. I'm stuck. Okay, we're almost there. Come on. Okay. Couple more. So now, I believe it's just on the observers I need. So what happens is as soon as a stem changes shape, like when it grows a pumpkin or a watermelon, the observer sees it move to adjust to grow a pumpkin, and then it will smash everything around it. Alright, so now we unleash the minecart. Keep going, but I can always just go down here and turn off a bunch of levers if I want it to not go. I just did it again. stuff up. We have one more thing we need to do. And that is... surround the outside. Oh, hell. Thought I could pick that up, right? Cool. Let me just block that area in. Actually, okay. Now if I ever need to get under here, I can, with that little trapdoor. Alright. Not too bad. Got a little farm going. Already got 6 pumpkins. A bunch of melons. Do I have a crafting bench? Sure do. There. I'll let that kind of just do its own thing. And I'll show you why I needed all those pumpkins and melons. Oh boy. Okay, so... all the rails... pistons... observers... bed. So I didn't need all those seeds, which is fine. Dirt. off to my villagers. Friend. Alright, so crafting bench, melon, every 6 pumpkins is an emerald, every 4 melons is another emerald, also a bunch of wheat. In the garden by my fishing area is all carrots and wheat, so that's just a manual garden at the moment. But yeah, that healed my pickup pretty good. Pardon me? Wait. There was only 4 of you the last time I was here. What have you been doing? And how did you... How'd you use that? That's his. 18 for amending. I need a couple more emeralds. Can I... Do any more trades? Alright. I haven't traded with you yet. Here's a bunch of chicken. Do you want to give me another mending book, please? Ooh, 17. Oh, come on. It's not that one of them is an imposter, it's just that that's actually the second time this has happened, where they'll just steal the book, the bookshelf or the lectern for themselves. So I'll have to come down here with a different job lot. Get out of the composter! Alright, well, that's pretty good. So anyway, yeah, that's the main reason I wanted to build the little melon and pumpkin farm, so I can get more trades with my farmer. So I'll leave all of these here. Yeah. Button. Activates the rail. I can just ride it all the way home. That's it. That's a successful stream. I got a couple projects done that I wanted to get done. Well, one project and then a bunch of another jump, so that's fun. Got a couple more mending books. All my good enchanted equipment already has mending on it, so I don't have to worry about that. Because I have my helmet with a bunch of good stuff, and then each of these should have it. And my bow. So. Ah, already producing. So good. And I can kind of see in there, which is nice. Just make sure we don't see any around the edges. Oh shoot. That belongs there. Glad I caught that before I left. Alright. So, yeah. That's pretty good. Well, yeah, if everyone enjoyed that, gonna cut down this bamboo as I say goodbye. Tim, thank you for hanging out a whole bunch. And if you're watching this on YouTube, which I may just post it as an extra video, because, well, I had fun. And just remember that that little pumpkin melon farm can easily be scaled up, I think, one bigger in each direction, because the water will hydrate the seeds for another spot, I think. I may have just made it a little smaller than I needed to for that reason. Or you can just make multiples of that farm if you're wanting to do that kind of thing. Statues next time, absolutely. And I am full of bamboo. I use bamboo to bake most of my iron and stuff, so. So yeah. I'll definitely try to figure out how to do a llama statue next time. It's always fun. But yeah, thanks for hanging out, Tim. Until next time, I've been Jayrod. Hopefully everyone has a great evening, and see you next time. Bye!